shouldn't. I don't know. We can just give them a meeting.
Right, security person.
Thank you very much.
Professor of Political Science and former Registrar at Rani Chennamma.
Professor K.K. Raina, I am Professor Attavalli, I am Professor Pagare. But actually yesterday he missed the Bisibela part, what we supplied to the other staff members. That was not so too, sorry sir.
Very esteemed principal of this great college, Dr. Subbarao Garu, my friend Dr. Arun Kumar Garu, the members of our NAC peer team, and members of the faculty of this great institution, ladies and gentlemen, and very ladies, I don't know what is the complimentary of that. So whatever it is, my best wishes to you, ladies and gentlemen. Friends, it has been a memorable time that myself and my colleagues from the NAC peer team have in this wonderful land that is Tenali, Vijayawada. The last 24 hours have been really very charming, very nice, very learning to each one of us. And when it comes to our own motherland, Bharat, and we see how vast, how diverse, how rich it is. Whether it is with the intellectual capabilities, the warmth of the people, and the greatness of our own people who go across the continents to make Bharat Mata the great. I wish this land grows further and further, and you, the teachers of this great institution contribute for the well-being of the society, the communities, the region, and the nation at large. When we say it is Vasudeva Kutumbakam, it is not only for the whole world, it is for our nation too. Because God has gifted this nation vast and wide boundaries and a rich human resource. Great resources given by the nature. I think it needs about 2 to 3 weeks back. It was a busy schedule in the meeting. I had that time and I got a call, sir, you have to go to Andhra Pradesh. And when I started looking at the erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, I asked them which part of Andhra Pradesh. They said Guntur. Many years back, when we used to travel from Delhi to Karnataka, we used to pass certain railway stations. That time it was not always by air. It used to be whether by this GT Express, whether it is Karnataka Express or and so forth. I said, yes, Guntur is there. And they said, you have to get down at Vijayawada, then go to Guntur. And there's a town, Tenali. It reminded me of the stories about the Tenali town. I said, I must see it. So friends, that's how we are here. I'm sure the same is going to be the version of my colleagues in the NACPIA team. At the outset, I thank the NACPIA team as well, who gave us a wonderful team of such learned people to work together. And since the day I descended in Vijayawada, drove to hotel, these two gentlemen were waiting for me. And I know Professor Phagare had started his journey from Kolhapur at midnight, didn't have his food till I reached. So, wonderful team. And when you were introducing us, Annapurni, that from this place, from this place, from this place, really I felt emotional at how big our country is, irrespective of our color, caste, creed, region, religion. Right, I am born there. So, I think we say Janam Bhumi and Karam Bhumi. Like, you know, for Lord Krishna, Kurukshetra was the Karam Bhumi. And yesterday when we had the artists on the stage, when there was an artist from Haryana, she was introduced as person from this holy land, the Bhagavad Gita. So therefore, my Karam Bhumi has been Punjab. And having spent a couple of years there as a teacher, as a learner, then I moved to Dehradun. So that is how the journey has been. So in this small room, we represent India in totality. Friends, when this institution was formed, I would say it was an idea of philanthropy. Great minds, great people, although they are not with us today, but can you imagine, it is mine, it is for my son, it is for my daughter, or it is for my relations. But I think those great souls, yesterday when we had a brief session with the alums, they said that this is a great institution, it's a temple, and indeed it is a temple, because it has given light, it has nurtured great minds, gave them a path for their progress and prosperity. So I think for me too, it's a temple. When I was going through the report, which I got from the NAC office, the first thing I saw was how old this institution is and created such great minds. Today we live in a very, very competitive world. This morning I was speaking to Dr. Arun Kumar in IQAC office that what are our challenges? We get new students. What has happened in between? To the teachers, because I am a teacher, I am a learner, I speak in that very tone. Have we lost something? Or society is enriching and they don't care for us. From 5,000 to 7,782 is a big decline in the number of India. I will not blame anyone except the fact that many institutions have come up. Education has gone to each and every corner of this nation. And each one wants to grow faster than the other. That puts a lot of pressure, a lot of challenges on each one of us. An institution which has a faculty strength of, sanctioned strength of 167 is running on 30 people. It is how much? It is, what percentage of that is it? It is too small. 167 to 30. It is even not even the 30%, not even the 20%, hardly around 17 to 18% strength. That means we need to revive those old values, old traditions. Tell us, here we have so many mothers, so many brothers, so many fathers and whatnot, because students look at us in that very perspective. Soon after going through the campus, I saw a wonderful infrastructure, and I see that the teachers are very much devoted. And when there is devotion, when there is infrastructure, I think it is very similar institutions also need to be taken that type of care. Our beloved Prime Minister always speaks about the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. I think we need to keep our institutions clean, our houses clean, our cities clean. And this cleanness gives a lot, much great vision, the vibrancy. If we have an environment where we have cleanliness, the research proceeds that, the teaching learning process proceeds that. And what is, like, where does goddess live? Where does goddess live? On special knowledge. At the same time, the responsibility of each one of us is to create knowledge. Otherwise, the knowledge was created about a century back. We are not studying those things. We are reviewing them and finally create new knowledge for the new generations. I think institutions of this size, this magnitude, this age, need to have the centers of excellences. And excellence as on date comes through such noble, innovative and creative teaching pedagogies which focus on building the student base, the student intellect. At one point of time, my friends, we used to create human resource for the neighborhood. And today neighborhood is not Guntur. Today neighborhood is not Vijayawada. It is not even Hyderabad. It is not Bangalore. It is New York. It is Beijing. It is Shanghai. It is Washington. It is Sydney Hall for constituting a gold medal. It is a great contribution. But yes, you can also use the resources of your alums, that where else they can still help. Sometimes in the jobs of our students, sometimes in the skill enhancement of those students, and at times showing them the rightest path. I also met one of the alums, don't remember the name. He said, I retired from here and now I am training and teaching students for IIT examinations, for NEET examination. I said, you are giving something great back to society. We have got so many things, we are blessed. But what we give back is what we have to think. Right? So I think that's a great source. There was also a suggestion and a comment that can we have some postgraduate programs also here, so that our daughters, boys and girls, need not to go to far distance from here. I would say we have taken the cognizance of all those suggestions and recommendations and try to put in the finest way in our report. I am sure the report speaks about the best practices. Certainly there are certain weaker things, weaker links, which we need to improve upon. Because no one is perfect, no institution is perfect. We do not talk about the idealistic way. So wherever there are shortcomings, think, introspect. There are various organizations, various bodies that are constituted under the aegis of IQAC, under the chairmanship of the principal of the college. Think, brainstorm sometimes. What do you need? Because mother gives many things if we ask for. Even sometimes she says that I am very busy, please hold on, please hang on, isn't it? If mother says so, what about the governments? The government is on the mother, isn't it? So therefore, I would say, you have to strengthen the hands of your beloved Prime Minister, beloved principal here, sit together, brainstorm. You may agree to disagree, and you may disagree to agree. But finally, it is this great institution which is going to be benefited from your experiences, from your expertise. I have a suggestion to make to the principal, because today we talk of faculty, refresher courses, continuing education program courses, the faculty development courses. If you are born here, brought up here, schooling here, old age here, everything here, you have not seen the world. But there are great institutions, both in this country as well as overseas, established institutions in this part of the country, down south, and north, east and west. They conduct such programs. If possible, Dr. Subba Rao, do depute one or two teachers in such programs. They will interact with the teachers there under the faculty development program. See what are the healthy practices, what are the best practices, and create USP, the unique selling point for this great institution. I am sure